I see how you are. Why you remember your Zoom settings? Hey, boy! I'm gonna tell you to stay Zoom. You're supposed to go back to default, stupid camera. Being as they got a sale on them shoulder roasts, I'm gonna go ahead and do one. Miss JB says this recipe is not as good as mine that I make, like mom's pot roast, just pot roast, beef pot roast, really my mom's recipe. But this recipe came from a lady at church, Miss Carol. After I'd been in the hospital for a week last year, they brought me this recipe of it. And after eating hospital food for a week, it was like the best thing I had tasted in a week. So it kind of stuck with me, and I like it. It's good. It's got golden cream of mushroom soup in it, and so it's got a little different flavor from the one that I make. But I like it, and Miss JV, like I said, says mine's better. But I'm going to go ahead and do it. So let me wrench that shoulder roast off, and then we're going to brown it in a pan with some seasoning on it. All right, so I got it down here, and it's got a lot of fat on it, and that's good. That's going to help with the flavor. We're going to put some Slap Your Mama on it. I think she used Tony's. Not going to put too much. But Slap Your Mama's got all kind of stuff in it. And I done wrenched it off. And I wrenched this pan out too. This little pan that had the diaper in the bottom of it. I ain't going to worry about patting it dry, because it's going to leak out some moisture when it's frying anyway. So we ain't worried about that. Just going to be more moisture in the pot. Lash pa la pa tot. Which means pay attention, or don't drop the ball, or don't drop the potato. Boy, get you some Earl. Use engine Earl. Better yet, use 90 weight. It stinks. Put it in a pot. And I'm not going to do this in a cast iron pot, because you really can't store a cast iron pot with food in it overnight in the refrigerator. Whereas in a stainless pot like this Lock Pot, Lock the Pot right there, I can keep that meat in there overnight in the refrigerator. Now, I ain't going to heat the oil first, because that's a wet roast. It's going to start popping like a fool. So we're going to put him down in there and go heat him up like that. And I'm going to put the lid on it too. That way it don't pop all over me and get in my eye. Yeah, that smoked shoulder. One of them was a little bigger than the other one, and it come out perfect. The smaller one, it dried out a little bit, but it was still good. Just put it in your Whopper Chopper or food processor and kind of pulse it, and then chop beef. Chop barbecue beef sandwich. Yum. The other one, I just sliced it up and chunked it on a sandwich, and it was very good. So, yeah, I got a dirty thing. I got to clean them dishes up because I ain't doing it yet. But I need to get this going, because it got cooked for a while on the stove. All right, I'm skipping steps on y'all. I'm sorry, boy. I just whack up an onion and threw it up in here. And it's going to start releasing some water. And you see all that brown goodness down there on the bottom? It's going to start releasing that too. Got to get it back over the fire. Buzz up in there, onion. Come on. Y'all have fun. Turn the fire up a little bit, GB. Where's your pop? Where's my damn pop? I see it. I ain't used that line in a long time. I used to lose them all the time. I'm getting better about that. this ain't a beef stew. This is Miss Hill's pot roast. Put a little tightening up from JB, because I don't think she put no wine in there. We will, though. Now, this wine got a real stopper. It's Cabernet Sauvignon. Washington State. Right? And down here, boy. I'm going to open the wine. So I got to open this. Smell that stopper. Smell like a stopper to me. And look, it say Columbia Crest on that. Three times. Must be three times Columbian Crest wine. Imagine that shit. See how this is starting to churn out? That's what you want. Golden onions. Gonna release all that flim flam and stuff from the bottom of that. And it smells righteous, my friend. We get a little bit of garlic in here. I got some sliced mushrooms going in. Fresh out the damn can with that juice. Y'all get happy in that. See how that one jumped? It was so happy. Did you see that? Some wine in that. If you was in New Orleans, eating at somebody's house, they would use this whole bottle. But I ain't New Orleans. I'm in Baton Rouge. Are you still recording, stupid? Yeah, I ain't told you to turn off, no. Let's get this roast in there with all that juice right there. Oh, I see sampler pieces right in that thing. I'm gonna wrench that off. Get all that juice off of that. Mm-hmm. Y'all come up to heat. Now we got some liquid in there. Let me put some garlic in. Stupid camera didn't record. I just hammered with my meat hammer about 5 toes of garlic. Put them in there. See them right in there? We're going to get them up under the juice. And cover the pot. Did you know when you put a cover on a pot, it raises the temperature in that pot about 10 degrees. Yeah, camera, don't fall down. We got to get that cream of mushroom soup in there in just a minute. Did you know? Imagine that. 10, 15 degrees, depending on how high you got the heat set. What I said that was missed while I was beating that garlic with that hammer, whooping that garlic with that hammer. In analytics, which shows you stuff about your YouTube channel. You can go in and see all kind of information about where you get the most views from, what country in the world, in the universe, the nuclear universe, the world. United States, naturally, I get the most views. And I appreciate everybody's views all around the world, but because I get them internationally, views. I think second is maybe Canada, and then many, many other countries. And it also breaks it down into a pie chart that, I see that light's in your eye again. It shows it by gender, like female and male. Used to be the males were watching my videos more than the females. Now the girls outnumber the boys on the views of the videos, and it's just a generalized all my videos. So, and I appreciate everybody watching And thank y'all, because I'm getting ready to come up on 2 million video views in probably another couple of weeks, and 4,000 subscribers coming up just any day now. Y'all are steady subscribing to my channel, and I appreciate that. I got to get the cream of mushroom soup, the golden mushroom soup, and all that stuff up in that. So let me pause and get another pop, because this one's about dead. Bought a stupid ass camera. I just opened this 100% delicious. Look, it says that on the top. Golden mushroom soup, and poured it in there. Let me wrench the can out. With some water. You can use wine. I already done put it in the fridge with the stopper back inserted. I need to add some more liquid to this. I just know. Just trust me, boy. I also need to start to say smell it for salt, but yeah. It ain't got enough salt. Let me tell you that right now. Let's go ahead and really taste it, the salt too. Need more salt. I'm just gonna use some of them little square cow cubes. Put them in there, because they got a little beef flavor too. And plenty of, more salt than anything else. Unless somebody done cut up some cow and put it in this little box here, a plastic tube. So we'll get, about three. Come out of there. Three of them little cow cubes, and go chunk them in there with some more water. Now I put them cow flavored cubes in this can of cream of mushroom soup. Water. And I like to do things differently on different parts of the stove. On this size pot, if you put it on the big burner, the heat kind of mushrooms out up underneath it, flares out, and it heats more the side and a little ring around the bottom of the pot, about like that. And that's good for simmering. If you want to cook something like sauteing or browning this, put it on a smaller burner, because it covers more of the center and outer edges, and it doesn't wrap around the sides as much. And that's fine, because you only got a little bit of oil in that. You really want to control your heat. Go ahead and put your pot in the oven. The stove don't know. The burners don't know I want this temperature, whereas the oven do. It got a thermostat. This one, all it know is, watch down here. Burner on. What temperature is that? How big is the pot? How much volume's in it? All that determines all that. Yeah, dirty stove, who cares? Housekeepers be coming this week. But you know, now you're on low. Well, what temperature is that? Depends on the size of the pot, how much volume's in it. Volume of liquid stuff and all that. We can go ahead and warm this can up on the little hobo burner right there. Get that water hot. Lash pa patat. Dump the damn thing in there with the pieces of cow. saved at Kang. I don't know why. Now let's cover it and let this go until it falls apart by looking at it. Now, this is JB's addition. We're gonna go ahead and put some carrots in there. And I also got some potatoes that I'm gonna stick in there. Now, I left them carrots old. I did peel them. You know, that one didn't look like it. Come on in there, boy. Yeah, you peel. Y'all all peel. Good. And rinse them. Let's go ahead and get us a potato and put it in there. And no, it ain't no damn stew. I got one red tater right there. There's some pop right here. You can put sweet potatoes in this too, yeah, boy. But we ain't gonna do it. Taters going in with some of that wrenching water. How about that there? Y'all gonna get happy in that. Put that top back on now so that heat don't just come out that pot, boy. Now, notice y'all asking me about ratios and rice and all this kind of stuff. For perfect rice, use extra long grain, number one. It's two parts water, one part rice, and some salt. It depends on how much you're going to use. About a half a teaspoon of salt for 1 cup of rice. Okay? That's what you want. That's your general rule. So, that's what I got right here. Down there, boy. I got a 2-to-1 ratio of water and rice. And really, I was supposed to bring that water to the boil first.
Yeah, you are.
And I forgot. So I done screwed up right there, right off the bat. So don't do it like that. We're gonna go ahead and put some salt in there and try to make it get right. So on the rice, bring your water to the boil, your salted water to the boil. Don't pour your rice in like I did. I messed up. But it'll be okay. I know how to deal with it. Bring it to a boil. Pour your rice in. It's going to reduce the temperature. Once it comes back up to the second boil, cover it 20 minutes. That's it. Perfect rice every time. Yes, it is. Yes, I'm telling you, boy, it is. You do have to put salt in the water. Or else. Alright, so I got a little small Losh Pop Potato right here. And I got some Dubon number 1 CV early June Petit Pois peas. And if you can't find these, you need to mail order them. These are the best peas in the world. These are sweet, sweet, sweet. And they're good with bacon, they're good with bell pepper, onion, and garlic, and all that shit. But all that's in that gravy from that roast beast. So we just go warm this up. This is all ready. And I'm so excited. Yep. Rice. That's really fine. Cajun loves rice. Now you can put hot sauce right on top of that and eat it just plain. Or with butter. and hot sauce. Eat that plain. So we got these petit pois peas down here. I want some of them with that juice on that rice. Just like that. A little bit more juice. Not too much, baby. But you gotta have some of that gravy. That's the bomb right there. Yum, my friend. So let's get us some of that. Some of them taters with the gravy. Some of them carrots. And more taters. What that gravy? See that rich gravy right there? Mm-hmm. Mushrooms and gravy. And gravy and gravy and gravy. All up on that rice. I'm gonna eat this with a spoon. This meat is like falling apart, tender. Look, watch here. See like that? See how that is? Yum, my friend. Get a little bit more gravy for that rice. And that's so fine. Don't get much better than that. My plate right there. Then we're gonna put some taters in there and let them cook for a while. My little Scooter, it's a precious boy, a Trail 110. I think it's an 84. Cool, huh?